spend our time not appeasing this theocracy, this anti-Semitic regime. We've spent our time denying it wealth and resources. So fewer resources to underwrite Hezbollah, to undermine the people of Lebanon, fewer resources to build up missile programs to threaten Israel, Europe, the United States if they get a long-range missile and they get it deployed to the right place, fewer resources to destabilize Iraq and Syria, and fewer resources to terrorize their own people as well.
Yom Kippur, known by many as the Day of Atonement, is a solemn day focused on prayer, repentance, and fasting, and is the last day of the Jewish high holidays.
The development of the Eastern Mediterranean should promote cooperation and provide a foundation for the durable energy security and economic prosperity of the entire region. We strongly support dialogue between NATO allies Greece and Turkey and encourage them to resume discussion of these issues as soon as possible. The mission of defending human dignity and religious freedom in particular remains at the core of American foreign policy. Every man and woman of faith is called to exercise a moral witness against the persecution of believers. Indeed, we're here today to talk about religious freedom. The very future of religious freedom depends upon these acts of moral witness. Nowhere is religious freedom under assault more than it is inside of China today. That's because, as with all communist regimes, the Chinese Communist Party deems itself the ultimate moral authority. An increasingly repressive CCP, frightened by its own lack of democratic legitimacy, works day and night to snuff out the lamp of freedom, especially religious freedom, on a horrifying scale.
We're praying for the president and the first lady that they'll have a speedy recovery. I spoke with the vice president's office this morning as well. We're taking this obviously very seriously, and we'll do everything we can to keep everyone safe.